When I was on rounds as a medical student, I met a patient with cystic fibrosis. And as we were discussing what was going on, that her disease is caused by a protein channel that's missing in the lining of her lung, she stopped me and said, "It sounds like you know exactly what's wrong, so why can't you fix it?" And I realized she's right. Why can't we fix it? So it can be easy to treat a disease sometimes caused by too much function, but it can be much harder if you're sick because you're missing something. So my lab is working on the idea of molecular prosthetics. That is, could we find small molecules that can do what the protein is supposed to be doing? In a sense, operating like a prosthesis on the molecular scale. We found what we think is a good candidate for a molecular prosthetic for cystic fibrosis. And the really exciting news is that it's a medicine that's already approved and available on the market. It's an ion channel forming molecule called amphotericin. Amphotericin is typically used to treat fungal infections, and it's been known for a long time to form ion channels. So we figured out a way to use the ion channel activity of amphotericin to hopefully help it treat people with cystic fibrosis. It's also possible to deliver amphotericin directly to the lung and thereby not get it into the rest of the body and avoid its possible side effects. Normally, the lining of your lung releases bicarbonate through the CFTR protein, and this protects your lung against infection. But if you're missing the CFTR protein, the bicarbonate gets trapped inside. We found that amphotericin ion channels can replace the missing CFTR protein, release the bicarbonate, and thereby restore your capacity to fight infection. We did studies both in pigs with cystic fibrosis as well as in lung tissue from patients with cystic fibrosis. And we found that in both cases, amphotericin was able to cause changes that are suggestive that you could restore the antibacterial properties on the surface of the lung. Even though amphotericin is not a perfect mimic of the missing protein, it looks like that imperfect mimicry might be enough to do a lot of good. There are exciting recent advances with small molecules that can bind to certain types of mutated CFTR proteins and help them work better. But there are roughly about 10% of patients whose mutations cause them to make no CFTR protein at all. So one important advantage of our approach is that in theory, it should work for all people with CF, regardless of the type of mutation, including people whose mutation makes no protein. A lot of important work remains to be done. We're hopeful that we could begin clinical trials soon to figure out whether this approach could work in people with CF. The same strategy might also apply in cases with other diseases where missing protein is causing the problem, and thereby represent a new way to think about addressing them in a general way.